People, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today it is time for part 2 of my collection videos. Today we're gonna cover all my foundations and concealers. And I'm gonna show you what I've got, how many I've got. I will count them in the end because I have a lot of foundations. I love trying and using foundations, one of the best things ever. If you wanna see this eye look, it's a little short, so it went up 3 days before this one. So if you want to see, then please go check that one out as well. It's a little shorts. And if you like these collection videos, then please like my video, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, would be amazing. And let's just get into my foundations and concealers. These are all my foundations and concealers. I'll get my concealers out of the way and we'll start with my foundation. That's all my foundations, all the foundations I've got. Most of them are drugstore. I'll guide you through them. We'll just start at the side. This is my Morphe foundation. This is in the color F2.2, and this is the matte foundation, Fluidity, my foundation. I really like this. It's my perfect color. Works really well with my skin. Really good. So yeah, I really like this one. It's a keeper. So yeah, of course, I'm just not a declutter people. It's a collection video. I will not declutter anything. I want to use and try out more of these. So yeah, that's the first out of the way. And we go to this side. This is my Maybelline Dream Matte BB Cream. I use this very occasionally at work when I don't feel like doing any makeup, but do look like a little bit of color on my face. I use this. This is in the color light medium. This is because of a German new Instagrammer and YouTuber that I bought this. This is from Regina, I think she's called. She's Russian German. She said this was really good. That's why I bought it. I've not used it that much time, so be sure. And I have not used it recently. So, but if you want to use me, if you want me to use any of these foundations, please do tell me. I'll try them out for you. No problem at all. This is my newest to the collection. I have this on my face at the moment. I did a little shorts video, just my eyes, and I wanted to figure out how the foundation would work because it's really liquidy. I don't know if you can hear it. I'll open it up. Yeah, this. She's shaking it. It's really liquidy. That's what it looks like. This is a serum foundation, not a coverage. This is a serum one. I do still want to do a video on it, so if you're interested in that, please let me know. But yeah, it is a foundation I have on in the intro and outro of this video. So yeah, if you're interested in that, let me know. Then we've got my Urban Decay All Nighter foundation. I like it. This is my light winter shade. So it's actually a little bit too light at the moment. I got this color coordinated 2 years ago in a shop in Amsterdam. But yeah, I do use it, but it's my high end, so I don't use my high end that much because I'm always scared of running out, even though you can see this part is empty and the rest is still full. So yeah, I like it. I will still use it even though it's 2 years old. I don't mind. As long as it doesn't reek or anything, I will keep using it. And I think the packaging is pretty, so yeah. Then we've got the other ordinary foundation. I'm not gonna do it in any order, by the way, I've noticed now. This is the other ordinary current foundation, is the coverage one. Again, there's a video of this up on my channel. Didn't like it my first time using it, but it's growing on me. It's working better now, and I figure out ways. Sometimes just a combination of stuff doesn't always work, or your skin is different. So never throw away anything when you try it a little bit more than just once. So yeah, I quite do like this now. I just didn't like it in the beginning. So yeah. Then you've got my Airbrush Flawless Foundation from Charlotte Tilbury. Unfortunately, a little bit too yellow for me, but I still do like it. I'm still going to use it. And maybe it's just in the summer, it's a perfect shade for me, but at the moment it's a little too yellowy, I think. I always keep forgetting how the color of the foundations is. I know how they work and if they work for my skin, but I seem to keep forgetting which colors they are. And then I put it on my face and think, oh, you're right, this was a little bit yellow one. So yeah, I think this is a little bit too yellow for me, but yeah, it's still an amazing foundation. I love it. I'll use it. I'll never get away of throw it away. Then we're going into drugstore. This is Revolution. I have quite a few of the Revolution foundations, to be honest. This is the Conceal and Hydrate. I like it. It works well. The color is good. It's nothing extraordinary, but it's just a nice foundation. To be honest, at the moment my skin is really not that good, but I mean my skin reacts to almost all the foundation quite well, so yeah, I quite like that. Then I've got my Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation. I love this. This is really good. It's in a good color. It's in the 02 Rose Beige. Yeah, it's a really good one. Again, this is a really liquidy one, but yeah, I don't mind it. It really, really works. Good coverage. It's really nice on my skin. Not gonna get rid of that. Then I've got the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. This is in the color... Where is it? Soft Beige? Yeah. Soft Beige is a light medium warm foundation. It's okay. It's good. Nothing special, but nice foundation. Works on me. Then we've got the Matte Base Foundation. And what I just said about trying foundation more than once, I've just tried this once and I hated it that day. So maybe I'll still try it again one day, but I've not done that yet. It's in the, I have all my foundation in F6, but those are all different in some shades. But yeah, I'll try it again, but my first time attempt at this, I hated it. So I'll hope next time I'll like it. This is my Essence Pretty Natural Hydrating Foundation. This is a new one. Like it, it's good. I don't know if the colors was right, but there is a, this is 060 Neutral Honey. There is a video of this again on my channel, the full face of Essence I'm using this. So yeah, just check it out if you want to see what I think about it, because I'm not sure anymore, but I think I like it. Then I've got my Primark. Again, this is a, there's a video on my channel for the Primark one. It's in the Sand 09, and it's just 3 euros. I mean, what can go wrong? It wasn't even that bad. It was okay. I appreciated this foundation. So yeah, that's nice. Then we have my Exit Revolution Luminous Foundation. It's good. It's nice. Nothing special. I think it got really hyped, this new Revolution brand, Exit Revolution. I bought a lot of their stuff in the beginning and then never again. I don't know. Just don't seem appealing. They made it so look so amazing, and I loved all, and I liked all the stuff I've used, but yeah, I've used it all once. Then I've got my NYX Born to Glow. Again, this is too dark for me. This is the color Soft Beige. Maybe in the summer when I'm really tan, but I haven't tried it yet when I'm really tan, because we couldn't go out that much in the summer. So I'll try it again in the summer. It's nice, I like it, this, the glowy version. It's not too matte. It's really nice for my skin. Yeah. So it's the wrong color, but I like the foundation itself. Then we've got the Seattle London Extraordinary Foundation. It's been gifted to me by my amazing friend, Kerry. I really like it. It's a good color. She had 106P silk. And it really works well for my skin, and I really like it. I'm definitely going to use this more. It's also a big tube compared to all the others. Normally are 30 mL, and this is, I think this is 50 mL. So yeah, quite like it. Then we've got my e.l.f. foundation. I like it. It's good. It's all free. 15 sunscreen, SPF 15 in it, and this is in the color Porcelain, which I'm not, and still this is a good foundation for me. So I don't know if this foundation would be good for lighter than me. If there, I also don't know if you have lighter shades, to be honest. I just always check for my own shades. Then I've got two of the same foundation from Colourpop. This is the No Filter Foundation. I've got the 95 medium and the 90 medium. This one is too orange for me, and I think this is a little bit too pink still, but yeah, this is, I bought this first, it was not exactly my color, and but I liked it, so I tried this color. It's still a little bit too dark for my winter, but I will probably mix them. I don't know sure about the color, but I love this foundation. It's good, it's nice. Yeah, I love it. Then we have the Glow and Conceal Revolution Foundation. Again, I like this. I have this in different number, I see F7. Yeah, you have to check with all the foundations, because they're not the right color colors as well. I always check the description and how they... I always go for light medium. I try to always go for light medium, neutral or pink. I'm at the moment the light color more pink, and I think in summer I'm more neutral, but... Yeah, like this. Good, nice. Then we've got my L'Oreal True Match, which is really going empty at the moment. I like it. It's good on my skin. I love it. I don't use it much in my videos. This is the color 5R5C Rosé Sand. Yeah, it's good. I like it. It's nice. I have it a while already. Then I've got my new Catrice foundation. This is True Skin Foundation. Again, love it. This is 02 Warm Beige. It's a good foundation. I appreciate it. And it's not that expensive. So I really like that. Like you can see, I have mostly drugstore. This is the Revolution Conceal and Define. The first one, I have the color F7.5. I like it. It's really thick. I haven't used it in a while, to be honest. Maybe I should try it again. But yeah, that's the foundation. And then I've got my Superstay 24 hour foundation. This is the older one. They have a new version of it now, of this now, and this is in the color 21 Nude Beige. Again, I've used it quite a lot, but at the moment not using it at all. Maybe we should try it again or get the other one, and then we'll see what to compare them or anything, but I don't know. Then I've got my Huda Beauty foundation. This is the first one. They haven't reformulated it now, but that's the older one. This is the one I've got. This is in the color Macaroon 230M. I like it. It's a thick AF foundation. I don't mind the smell of it. Works for my skin if I'm careful. I have days that I'm really dry and I don't use it then, but other days when my skin is normal and not acting up, it works good. And it's nice full coverage one, which I appreciate. Then I've got my Fit Me foundation from Maybelline in the color 1125. And again, I like this. It's good. Works well for me. And yeah, we'll definitely use more. And then I've got my CC foundation from Revolution Pro. Again, I like it. It works. It's a good moisturizing one. It's not too full coverage, but I don't mind. I switch them up all the time, to be honest. So yeah. That's all my foundations. Let's go in with my concealers. Let's get them in front of me again. In front of my camera, because I'm sitting quite weird next to it. So yeah, like I said, these are all my concealers. Let's get them in front of me. Can you see them all? I think so. But I'm not showing you where I put my foundation and concealers. I'm in a quite a small apartment. I don't mind, because I'm alone and I don't need more room. But that means I don't have my makeup stuff at one place. They're all scattered around my apartment. So yeah, that's why I just showed you like this on my table. And then I'll put everything back. Foundation. I really enjoy showing you my collection, to be honest. But yeah, let's just start from the side again. I'm not gonna put them in any order. This is my Morphe. This is my newest concealer. I like it. It works really well. I was surprised by it, to be honest. This is in the color C2.15. Quite surprised by it. I quite like it. It works well with the foundation, and I've now used it a couple of times with different foundations, and I like it. It's good. I have no problem with it at all. Then I have my Born to Glow concealer. This is in the color Vanilla. And yeah, I like this. I like this concealer. It's a good one. It's a nice and dewy one. You have to set this. I have to set this on my face at least. But yeah, quite like it. This is way lighter than the foundation, which is a little bit too dark for me. So yeah, like that. Then I've got the Conceal and Hydrate Makeup Revolution Concealer. This is in C4. And yeah, I like this as well. It's a good concealer. I should use it a little bit more, because yeah, I have so many concealers that you can see. I always forget which one I have to use. So try something else. Maybe a little bit more. I've used it on my channel, so you've seen it before. Then I've got my e.l.f. 16 Hours of Camo Concealer. This is the original one. This is in the color Light Beige. This is the original concealer, Camo Concealer. We also have an hydrating now. I actually like this. I don't mind it. I don't mind the this one. The normal eye Camo Concealer. It works well on me, but then again, I don't have that much wrinkles yet. Hopefully they'll stay gone, but we'll see when we get older. Then I've got my All Nighter Concealer. This is in the color Light. Then we've got my All Nighter Concealer. This is in the color Light Warm. I love it. This is an amazing concealer. I have no words. I don't think there's money much left into it anymore, but even if it's empty, I'm gonna keep it for the packaging for my pieces that have been set out around my apartment. I love it. And we've got my Super Size Revolution Concealer and Define Concealer. Again, a good concealer, I like it. This is the color C5. Yeah, I love it. It works well. It's a good one. Then I have my very old Maybelline. This is almost empty. You can see there's just this little bit in it. I cannot see which two I can see. Oh, I have the color 02, which you can see still in the end, but this one is so rubbed off. This is one of my first concealers. I don't even know if I've used it on camera. I loved it back then. I have finished two of these more. This one's almost finished as well, but I haven't used it in ages. But yeah, I love to have an oldie in my collection, to be honest, so I will stay here. Then we've got a Beauty Box version. This is the MTA Makeup Melos Active Eyelight Corrector. I've used it and tried it three times, and that's it. It's more of a eye cream under your eyes than a really concealer, but it also says corrector, but I don't know. I don't know how to use this product. If anyone have any tips how to use this product and how to work it, then let me know. I have no clue. Then I've got my Huda concealer. I have two of these. Where's the other? Yeah. I have different colors. I bought a cookie dough. The first was too dark, like you can see. Then I bought coconut flakes, which is perfect. My perfect shade. I bought this year. If I buy any Huda Beauty products, it's going to be on sale. So mostly for the Black Fridays in November, I always go stack up on my Huda Beauty goodies. So yeah. I bought this one a year before and this one this year of last time, so because I wanted the right color of that concealer. Then I've got my Wet n Wild concealer. This is the concealer corrector in Fair Beige. I don't like it that much. Don't use it. It's just in my collection. Then I've got another Beauty Box concealer thingy. This is from BB. I have no clue, I never use it. I should maybe start using the green. It looks fine. Start using the green for concealing my red spots, but I don't know. Never feel like it, so never use it. Then I've got my True Skin from concealer in Warm Vanilla, and I believe this is the wrong color for me. I really do like it, but I never use it because it's too dark. Again, this is Hot Makeup, if I'm correct, Beauty Box item. I think I broke it when I used it, because the first time, oh, it feels leaky. Yeah, well, I don't like it. I've just got it in my collection, because the packaging looks quite kind of cute. But it's one of those turny thingies, and I think I broke it when I got it. Then I've got my Jeffree Star concealer. This is in the color C9. I love it. I will use it up, and I don't know. What do you guys think? Because I love his makeup, and I would love to review his makeup still on my channel. But do you think he's too controversial, or do you want me to see using his products? You tell me, please, and I'll let me know. What you want me to do. I'll still keep using this because it's amazing, and I still keep using all my products, but should I do it still on my channel, please let me know, because I don't want to support him, but I do love his products. He's controversial, but his products are amazing. This is my Manicata Beauty Step 1. This is the Prime Time. I think this is more of an eye primer. I never use it. This came in a beauty box. I maybe should start using it for my as an eye primer and see if it works, because it just look pretty. Then I've got two Colourpop concealers. These two I've got again separately. I've started with my light 10 and now I've got a light 12. This is a little bit more pinky, this is a little more yellowy. Both light, both perfect. I love them. I love the formula. They changed the packaging apparently because now it's matte and it was not before. But yeah, I love both. I use them regularly. Good concealers. Then I've got my Tarte Shape Tape concealer because of course I had to get it. Everyone has it. I had to have it too. It is in a 22N. Light neutral. It's good. I like it. Works on me. I will use it occasionally in my channel. So yeah, you've probably seen it already. Then I've got the XX Revolution. This is the CX 4.5 concealer. I like it. It works. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like I'm coming back to my standard concealers. I use my Huda Beauty and my True Skin and my ColourPop. And I use every single time the same. So maybe I should try and switch it up because that's a good one too. Then I've got my Catrice Liquid Coverage Concealer. I do love this. It's good. Waterproof non-transfer, says. I've not tried if it's waterproof. This is 005. This is 005 Light Neutral. That's a good concealer. I like it. I've used it a couple of times. So yeah. Okay, good one. Back. Getting to the end of this little video. I've not swatched anything. I'm not swatches. If you want to see swatches or anything, let me know. But now you at least know what is my collection. And this is my Essence Stay 16 hour all day. And this is in the color 20 Soft Beige. It's a good concealer. I like it. Nothing special, but it's nice. Then I've got a, what the hell is this? Golden Rose Stick Concealer. I never use it. I think I've only swatched this and never use it on my face. This has come in a beauty box. I don't know. I just feel stick concealers is not so my thing. So that's why I never tried this one. Does this have a color? It's in the color 02. So yeah, it looks pretty. It's in my collection, but I never use it. Then my newest one, this is my Ordinary Concealer High Coverage Formula. It's good. I like it. This is in the color 1.2P. I love this concealer. It's not full. It's a half concealer. I could have contacted them and asked. I asked them if it was normal, and but I did not get a new one or anything, or I don't know, I'm not this kind of person. I just use it and probably never buy it again because it's half full. But it's really good and it's really nice coverage. But like you can see, I have enough concealer, so why bother when a tube is just half full? Then I've got my porcelain stick concealer from Primark. I have this for a full face of Primark. I have used it that one time. I should use it more and try more, but I don't the reach for this because again it's a stick concealer. I don't know. Then I've got a Paesa concealer which I did use. You can see here, see? It's again from a beauty box. This is a color. It says a color. Yeah, medium beige. Yeah, medium beige. It's okay. I like trying new stuff. I don't mind getting these in beauty boxes, but the annoying thing is, this is good for me. And it's just good for me, which other people are gonna like it. I assume beauty boxes go to different kind of skin tones than just me. So yeah, I hate that they put those in there, but I'm a lucky kind of girl with that. So yeah, with my skin tone, but it's just awful for other people, to be honest. Then I've got an oldie but goodie. The Instant Anti-Age Eraser Concealer from Maybelline. This is 01 Light. Like you can see, I've used it. I've emptied out two more of these already. I haven't used it in a while, so maybe start using it again or not, because look at the cap. Let's see how the sponge looks like. Oh, not as bad as I thought it would, but yeah. Again, a good concealer. Haven't used it in a while because I've got a lot. Then I've got my e.l.f. Camo Concealer in a satin finish. It is the hydrating version. I like it. Works well. Like you can see, I stack mine vertically. It's good. It's nice. It's hydrating. I like it. I like the other one as well. I do like this little smishing bit when I have dry days, but it's a good concealer, no problem with it. Then I think this is one of my favorite Revolution concealers. It's the Conceal and Define Infinity one. This is in the color C6, and this is really, really good. I like it. It's way thicker than the other parts, and I like it. It's good. Then I've got again a brightening concealer. This is in the Paesa. I don't know what the color is. 02 Natural Beige. And again, this came in a beauty box. And again, I'm lucky. I'm with a good skin color. But I don't get why you put concealers in a beauty box. Yes, I do like it. Yes, I've tried it. It's okay. But it will only work on me. And if I'm correct, they only have three or two or three shades. So why? Okay. That's my rant over. Then I've got my last concealer. This is the Revolution Pro Full Coverage Concealer in C6. I have used this, but I can't remember if it was any good, so I have to try it again. I think this is the right color for me, but I've not tried it in a while. So yeah, that's my collection. Just like you can see, that's my collection. That's all the concealers and foundations. You've seen them all. You've got them all. I will go back to you seeing my face and doing my outro for this lovely video. Let me know if you want me to try anything on camera or the combinations you like me to use, or yeah, just let me know. And thank you for watching. Well, that's it, you people. That is my concealer and foundation collection. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you liked the choice I've got. If you want me to add things to my collection, then please become a Patreon. I've got a Patreon now, so if you guys would like to support me every month with a little bit, I have a Telegram group at the moment. We have a little group there that we'll talk to each other. It's not that big yet, so if you would like to join, then please do. And it would be amazing so I can buy more makeup and more things for my channel, because that's what I want to use it everything for. So yeah, if you're interested, please do that too. And otherwise, just subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, give me a like. It would also already work so much for me. It would be amazing. So yeah, it's your choice. Don't feel obliged to do so. It's not you don't have to. You just do you, let's be real. But it would be amazing if you could. But that's it. You don't have to. So yeah, I'll hope you enjoyed my little collection foundation video part two, my collection. And yeah, see you in the next one. Bye!